Wendy, thank you for the ride.
Hi, Alexis. Sorry you got back so late. I hope your boyfriend doesn't mind.
I texted him earlier and it shows he read it. I think he's okay with it. I think he's already asleep. Thank you for worrying, Wendy.
Okay.
Have a good night.
Same to you.
Sorry. My friend wanted me to stay for the birthday cake. I couldn't say no.
It's 10.
I texted you earlier so you wouldn't be worried. And I told you my friend would drive me home. It's my best friend's birthday party. And you know how much she means to me. I thought you were okay with it since you read it. I'm sorry.
Why are you moving away from me?
Because you seem mad.
Oh, honey. I'm not mad. I'm just upset. You didn't keep up to your promised time. It's fine, Alexa. I understand. It's not like you lied to me. I know you would. Never do that.
Thank you.
So how was the movie you saw with Ryan last week? Was it any good?
I heard it's a comedy.
It was okay.
Why didn't you tell me you went to see a movie with him, baby?
I just went to see a movie with my friend, Brooke.
You disappoint me, Alexis. You're just not the good girlfriend you once were.
No, I just needed some breathing space, honey. I'm with you every day, and I just need some time with my friends, too.
But going out to see a movie with Ryan? You're crossing the line. You know that, don't you?
Brooke, I don't know how to make you happy anymore. You used to be so sweet, but now you're just so different. No, Brooke, don't do this. Please just let me go. Please just let me go. Please don't hurt me again. I love you.
You disgust me.
I love you. Will you